we have Jen here, and if you need to know anything about me, so I think that healthy hair is beautiful hair is healthy hair. So we have just gorgeous healthy hair on Jen here, but I'm going to show you how I'm going to transition this look and easily make it like easy beachy wave, and we hear that term so much, but I'm going to show you just by switching up this part and putting a little bit of product, it's going to quickly transform.
So on Pega here, what we've done is a beautiful color placement, kind of inspired by like an oil slick effect in it. And what I want to show you how to do is to be able to expand this shape to really expose a lot of those colors. I'm going to be working with one of my favorite products for that, which is Redken Triple Dry 15. You're going to spray that on. It's going to give it texture and movement. And then we're going to add some accessories, because accessories are what's up if you've been looking at Instagram these days.
That's true. So this is Jaden, and on Jaden's hair, I gave her a multi-dimensional red copper with pink pieces. So what I'm going to do, I've already styled her using Sebastian Dark Oil to give some body, and then now going in and changing her style up, giving her something that's a bit more power woman-y, shaped off her face, and I'm going to just add in maybe an accessory if I feel left out or I'm having serious FOMO.
I like that power woman-y. That explains Sonia and Atigle right there. Power woman-y. Okay, so speaking of power woman, I'm going to do a little power pony here, you guys. I am actually working with this string here. I have it part of the way done. I'm going to explain to you guys what I've done. I put a ponytail section in, and then I have this string, and then what I'm doing is I'm wrapping the string twice around, nice and tight, and you guys can see I'm directing in front, so I'm creating a shape where the direction and the tension is creating a ponytail that's lifting this direction, and then every second wrap I'll hold with one hand and then gently take a little slice of the hair underneath it. And let it fall so that it spaces it out. And you can see how it starts to create a spaced fountain. So I'll just keep repeating that all the way through in this until this becomes like a nice fountain effect ponytail.
All right, so we have a beautiful blonde balayage here. So I love dressing blonde balayages because when you bring them all up and make them really dramatic, you could see the highs and lows within the color. So we just started with a horseshoe-shaped section on the top of the head, did a little twist, pulled it all back, and then started pulling the pieces forward so you have nice texture in the crown area. Then I clipped all the ends to the side, working on the bottom, bringing everything to the center. And I'm using hairpins to just get some dimension in the highs and lows as I use my spray and start to shape a really kind of dramatic, exaggerated. This is really great for weddings or any kind of really formal looks that you're going to do. And I'm going to bring the sides all back into this and then drop that top section and swirl back into that base.
Loving that texture, Nick. I'm over here too. I've got this beautiful woman, Miriam, and as you can see, we have some color going on in here, but what I'm trying to do is create a really neat, different type of texture on smooth hair, not using a hot tool. So how I'm doing this is I'm actually using my bobby pins. As we once knew, we didn't want to see the bobby pins. Now it's cool to have bobby pins in the hair, right? So we're accessorizing it with colored bobby pins that are opposite of her hair color. I'm putting them in, and then I'm actually just pinching through this texture and creating a little bit airiness and trying to pull out some of that color so you guys see it.
All right, beautiful. So hi guys, I'm Bikila Riley, and here, the word of the day is texture. And what I've created here is basically a frothy texture set. What looks like to be regular spirals, I am stretching them out. And this was wanded with a regular wand. However, the hair was pre-stretched as to not take out all of the natural texture, so you still see that organic movement of the strand, and wanded. So instead of just raking them out, I'm going to stretch them. And I'm sort of scrunching that back. And this is going to create a frothy and more voluminous effect to give her a really, really voluminous texture look.
Voluminous. It was hard to say, huh?
Voluminous.
Sounds awesome, team. Good to be here. Hi, Orlando. Can we have some noise out there,
exactly,
please?
Exactly. A little energy, y'all.
How you doing? Hey, look, I'm going to be working on a look that is very European-inspired. What we're seeing in Fashion Week around the world. This is a shape that we saw in London, which London Fashion Week sort of pushes it a little bit more Danielle is also working with the bobby pins and accessories the team has been talking about. So with my shape, we've just worked some heat protection product in the hair to blow dry the hair flat and then just work a little bit of texture with the iron. And then we've used some pomade just to really blow dry and cool air to get it anti-gravity off the face. And the shape that I'm going to be building up is really to hug the head shape. So we create two textures, from shiny and flat to more of a disheveled texture, but really hug the head shape with the pin. So I'm going to keep working through, and we'll have a look at it once we finish up there.
So if you haven't taken a look at Ulta Beauty in a while, we have a ton of leaders at the booth. We're doing crazy cool hair all weekend long, so please stop by the booth and take a look at what we're doing, hear more about all the great things happening at Ulta Beauty. But for now, you guys want to see some more beautiful models?
Yeah.
All right, let's bring out our next set of models.
Wow, I really don't think we have enough models up here.
Wow, it's very colorful up here. What do you guys think?
Someone get a photo of this.
All right, D-Lo, take it away.
Okay, so I'm just finishing up Jen here, so I quickly transitioned this style from being like really soft and glamorous to now really sexy and cool. I used the same spray that I was using to do her hair, which is the Kendra Professional Dry Oil Control Spray, which is a really awesome combination of moisture and control. I'm going to use on Ariana, who has this really awesome, beautiful texture. And I love that at Ulta, we're really celebrating diversity and different cultures and different backgrounds, which means we see lots of different hair types. So Ariana is a great example of what we're seeing here. We're just really embracing the natural curl texture. Even here, what I call this little, you might call frizz, I call it a halo, if you will. We're seeing this really finished, beautiful look with a little accessory. And then we have over here, this is like my Kacey Musgraves at the Met Gala situation. Look at this. She has like a little bejeweled situation here, which we're always seeing. And this is, again, what I'm talking about. Healthy, beautiful, shiny hair, getting it to look really perfect and effortlessly. That's my vibe.
Oh, perfect. Perfect segue, okay, because we just finished her hair, and I popped in a vibes moment because you haven't met her, but working with her, she's definitely a vibe, okay? So from her, you can see how we really expanded out that shape. And what we were doing was simply taking the curl and pushing at each wave between your two fingers. What that's going to do is blossom it out to give you more volume, but keeping the integrity of the hair. So very different from going in and teasing and back combing for the volume. Now, let's take a look at, I've got two models named Rachel. So Rachel 1 and Rachel 2. Now, Rachel 1, what we were doing was inspired by like a festival moment that we're seeing. So if you tip her head down, you can see on the camera that this is actually all safety pins that we use. And all we did was simply bead the safety pins, and we have two braids going through that we've attached them across. Now to add that through underneath, we have a braid running up the back that you can't see, and all that's serving as is an anchor to pin in these little chains of safety pins that we link together with the beads. So it's just giving it a really cool festival vibe. Then, like you've been hearing us say about pins, we've done a cute little crop faux bob moment happening, working with some waves in the hair and pinning them with these beautiful rhinestone pins. So definitely check out Ulta Beauty. We have a ton of great accessories, but don't forget, you can make them yourself with some safety pins.
Oh.
She's crafty.
Craft corner.
So on Jaden's hair, I did end up using a couple of accessories. I felt as if I was a bit pressured to do so. I'm joking. But in my color with Jaden's hair, we did light colors of coppers and reds. But what I feel about color of a really great redhead is to always add pieces of vibrant pink. So that's what I've done with her hair here. So on my model here, Amy, and on Amy's hair, this is all of her own hair, everything. I will part it down the center. You can see this is everything she has. She has got a lot of hair. And what I went in with my mosaic technique on a dark background and just lightened it up using fashion colors. I used our Wella Color Fresh Create just to give her some vibrancy and to add some dimension in that beautiful thick hair that she already has. And here on my other model, Hannah, on Hannah's hair, She loves it undercut. She likes it short. I'm really into pops of yellow, maybe because it's spring. But yellow and gray and blondes all blended together using my twisting technique. Thank you.
Gorgeous. Woo. Okay, so you guys, you can see here, finished result, I was able to tie that. Because I over-directed, you can see now I have this control. It creates this beautiful kind of fountain effect that gives you like a dramatic kind of silhouette and shape. There is nothing special. This is just string that I got from this French store called Joan Fabrique.
Ooh, that was fancy.
Not special at all.
Joan wow. Fabrics.
I got my
like $2.
Gals.
Like Tarchet.
I'm a big believer, though. I like to keep something soft so that every angle you can see when you pull all the way out, there's something soft that's like capturing. So from a photographic standpoint, she's got this soft piece here. As she's being looked at like from the front, she's got a little bit of soft feminine feel here. I'm going to step back now while you guys can kind of see these from all angles and talk about my other two models. So first time Ulta Beauty, we've actually had boys on stage, which is super cool because we're all thinking
bring on the men.
Inclusivity means men too, right? So I wanted to just talk about his hair really quickly. He's got amazing, cool, thick hair. The thing with guys' hair that I think is really cool and it's on trend, actually the camera right now from the back is actually perfect if you guys bring that up again. Whether it's a tight fade like mine or it's full on the sides, the thing that makes it on trend is right down here, come down a little lower, is just a nice clean taper. There you go. So no more hard lines in the necklines for boys. A nice clean taper in their hair is on trend. His hair is great. I'm going to use a little bit of this color illuminator spray from Lonza to just kind of piece it out and really give it like that shine and texture so it just feels easy and disheveled. I think as hard as guys work on their hair, it should always feel and look effortless. David, we know your vibe on that.
That's my effortless vibe.
Over here, you guys, love the iridescent vibe. If you guys look at this color, there are so many different colors at play here. There are yellows, there are limes, there are pinks, there are blues. But from when you stand back, it looks very iridescent. So it's a great way to play with a lot of different pastel tones and create like an iridescent vibe just with some direct dyes and the way that you place them. I want to give a little shout out to Dina Galanos, one of our design team members, for that color placement. You guys, give it up for her. Nick?
All right, so just wrapped up. I like to say this is the perfect look to go grocery shopping. Nice and dramatic.
Literally me.
So lots of highs and lows within the style, lots of interlocking pieces, a little bit of bedazzle in there. I love this for a really formal, beautiful bride, beautiful night on a black tie event. But then go to something a little bit more fun and cool is this cool chick. I love, love, love right now. Using fashion colors, but in a very wearable, beautiful, and kind of expensive way. So this is, both of these models are Matrix Soul Color Cult. I went in and base shaded her with a violet first, with a pre-tone, then went back in with our bubblegum pink and clear all the way to the end, so she has a nice gradation of tones. And then our beautiful copper here. This is the orange from Soul Color Cult. Again, pre-lined her to like a level 7, 7.5, really gold undertones there, and then went and popped in that orange color to really bring out the texture in her hair. What do you guys think?
Amazing.
Beautiful. Awesome.
I love that we're a luxury elevated hair color. So same thing. We use Soul Color called a Miriam. I gave her a really editorial feel with the use of the bobby pins and pulling this texture out, kind of accenting through some of that color. But I do believe that there is that elevated luxury feel that you can do. And as you take a look at these two beautiful models, I'm clearly a hippie at heart because I've got to live through their fashion. But we've got this gorgeous Soul Color Cult rainbow happening. And again, it's just melting. Using the color wheel to actually melt that rather than five different colors, using three different colors, so thinking outside your box. And then our gorgeous spin on a just beautiful ombre that's happening with the balayage painting right now. So
nice.
Beautiful. Very cool. Beautiful. So as you can see, hi, I'm Pekila. As you can see, I love skinny hair. The bigger the hair, the smaller the waist. But speaking of...
love that.
Good to know.
I like that one.
I'm going to grow my hair out.
Ulta Beauty is all about inclusiveness. And, of course, without texture, you don't have inclusiveness because someone would not be being themselves. So, as you see, we are showing different ranges in texture. With her hair, my beautiful model, I think one of the most impactful things that you can do with textured hair is to add color and add shape. So in this case, this is a wet and go. A lot of girls want to have that curly definition, but without adding heat to her hair. This would we use the Mizani curl enhancing lotion to give her definition, but not where she wouldn't have volume. Create a little Bantu knot effect, which can also be a set, but also a feature, and just really let that speak for itself, the color and the texture. And this beautiful model, let's turn and show them what it's all about.
Love.
Another accessory moment.
We're a little extra today.
Subtly speak to texture. But yeah, these are our girls, and it's all about color, shape, and really celebrating the story of texture.
Beautiful. Perfect.
Woo! Beautiful. All right, so I finished my look, Fashion Week look. So as you can see, just you're seeing a lot of shapes. Now, we need to look at things with maturity with our eyes as hairdressers. We can take inspiration from anything, but it's up to us to make it commercially viable in the salon and your clients. So what we're looking at is shape here, whether it's a haircut or color. The shapes that we're seeing are very tight and head-hugging, but growing out. So this is my look. You'll see the two-tone texture from the pomade into the drier product through the ends. Very disheveled through the ends. We've just worked with the curling iron, not setting it, but just getting some looseness, and then working the bigger bobby pins through to secure that head shape, but very random to give it more of that like ID, hunger kind of magazine look. Then with my models back here, same sort of vibe. Emin was talking about trend earlier, going for a really Gucci kind of vibe with the different patterns and maybe something you wouldn't, you know, usually wear together, maybe all pink or all flowers, but we want to break it up. Been inspired by Gucci lately. And so same with the hair, very James Dean, a little bit growing out through the sides. And also what Pekila was saying, work with different textures. For us as a brand, it's not about doing one type of hairdressing. We have something for everybody.
Absolutely.
So we're looking forward to seeing you at the booth. Thank you for your time. We really appreciate you. Thank you. Yeah.